Us older types in the paddock are happy to see this kid, Robert Wickens, in an Indy car, because we've said for the last 10 years this is where you belong. And I think to be within a second, a quick time after jumping in this thing the first time is pretty damn impressive.
Yeah, I don't know what the actual gap was to the leader, but it's fun. You know, the team's doing a great job. They're treating me well. The car is very easy to drive, well, balance-wise. You know, obviously, to extract the lap time out of this thing's tough. Driving Road America for the first time in 10 years is an eye-opener. I miss this place. I mean, I always told everyone in Europe, like, DTM should come here because it would make for a great show. And so just to drive here again is just a blast. The carousel is still blowing me away. I'm still not flat, so every lap I'm kicking myself, telling myself that I need to do it, and I just like lift without wanting to. So, no, it's a big step, but we'll see. I mean, I don't know if Mikhail's going to be here tomorrow or what's going on. So, just kind of going session by session, and you know, if I get to do the race, then I'll be really happy.
You adapted pretty quickly in the test, as I recall.
Yeah, well, Sebring's a short lap, right? So, the thing is with Sebring, like, I feel like I'm adapting at the same speed rate, but you do so many more laps than Sebring, right? It's a 50-second lap, where here's a 1 minute 40, whatever it is, 42. So, yeah, that's the big thing for me is, like, I'm trying to learn and trying to cope, but, like, you only kind of get, like, 8 shots at it. Like, free practice one, I think I did, like, 10 laps or something with the red flag, and then today I did 17 in the afternoon. But it's, you know, in Sebring, in a 45-minute session, you could get, like, 60 laps if you wanted to, you know? So it's... No, it's going well. The team's helped me a lot along the way, coaching me from in the car, looking at the live telemetry, driver coaches outside. You know, they're taking good care of me.
The DTM's a steady paycheck, and everybody's happy you're making a living. But I think there was this, a lot of us were, like, really depressed that you went to GP3 and then you went over there and they liked you immediately. And it's hard to turn those people. When somebody wants to pay you to drive a race car, it's hard to say, no, I'm going to go stay and try and find a $5 million sponsor and be an open wheel.
Well, exactly. Well, the big thing for me was I was still going after Formula One at the time, and I was reserve driver, did some testing, and life was looking great, and then suddenly I was like, oh, you need this money to get
even though you were doing a good job of testing.
Yeah, to get the drive, and then on the contrary, I had a contract for Mercedes where I was earning money with one of the best manufacturers in the world, and, you know, I mean, it's can't turn it down, really. So I'm super happy where I am. I mean, you never know what cards could have played in different orders, but I'm happy to say that I'm a professional driver, and I have been for a few years now, and hopefully I can keep doing it till I retire.
Every time we go to Toronto, people are like, yeah, there's always a guy's got a sign, where's Robert Wickens? You know, I mean, there's a lot of people that still support you to be an open-wheel race driver. But I think the thing that's interesting about your career is that you were so successful as a teenager driving. You know, we were talking to Paul Tracy, he was only 16 or 17 years old. Jesus Christ, he should have been in a Formula Ford. No, you made that kind of progress that quick.
Yeah, I think I tested an Atlantic for the first time at 16, so it was, well, that's the benefit of Red Bull, right? They throw you in at the deep end and say, swim, kid.
Yeah.
And if you do, you make it to the next level and the next level and the next level. So it's, you know, I'm so fortunate with the career that I have. But, yeah, a little bittersweet that I'm not here in North America, but I'm really happy in Europe.
All right, last question. If Honda can get Mercedes, and then Zach Brown can talk Mercedes into building an Indy car engine, we can see you at the Indy 500. I've got this all figured out.
As long as there isn't any conflicts, because I don't think I could put Alonso and miss a race.